One, this is Kim Townsend with Kim Town. This tutorial is for the Diversity CMS website, version 1.6.1. It's the latest version that we have out for Diversity. We are going to log into the editor, and you would have a link with your email that you get. Once your site is in place, you'll get an email with a link to your actual website and then a link to the customization part of it, which is your CMS. So we're going to work with the Text Elements tab today, and the title would be the text that you see in the top of your browser bar, so you can change this to anything that you want. I recommend keeping it under probably about 100 characters, 80 to 100 characters. Just keep it short and sweet and to the point, and that will help you with your search engine optimization also. So your title would go there. Your footer would go here. You can add anything you want here. You can add links. You can change the font. You can change the size. You can change the style, the color, the alignment. And if you want to add bullets, you can do that also. Make sure that if you ever see this little save button here, anytime you make a change here, you'll want to click save and then commit changes before you go to your site, because you won't see any changes unless you do those two things. If you go to another tab, then you've lost everything that you've done here. So make sure you save that page and then commit your changes and then go view your site. The contact page, you can put any information here. Again, you can have links. You can change all of your styling, your fonts, and everything just by using the editor here. Once again, make sure you save and commit changes before you go to view your site. Your info page, you can have any information you want here. Again, you can change your styling, change your fonts, change your colors. You can do bullets. You can add links. If you wanted to make certain areas a link, you would just highlight and you would just add the link, and then it puts a link in there for you. You can see that, how the mouse changes into a finger. Again, make sure you click save and commit changes before you leave off the page. The background color is simply that. It's the background color of the website. If we click on there, all this white that you see around here is from here. If we go and change it, we click save, commit changes, go back to the website and refresh. You can see that it's now gray. These up here will always stay white. The background will stay white and the text will stay black. So keep that in mind when designing your site. Now, if you want, you can add the logo up here with a white background. So it'd be your whole title bar up there would be white. So that would look nice. The portfolio text color, when you click on portfolio, it would be this color here. Right now it's black with a rollover of red. So you can see that here. And your portfolio text size, obviously, is what size you want it. The font that you want it. This is where your stat counter, your Google Analytics, any of your site counter code would go here. Again, make sure you save and commit changes before you leave that page. Here is the email address that you'll put in when somebody fills out the contact form and clicks submit. This is where the email will go. So make sure that you put in the correct email address there or it'll never get delivered to you. So just double check that once you put it in. Again, make sure you click save and commit changes. Then you can go to the site and view your changes. That's the Text Elements tab. If you have any questions, just let us know.